warp drive active. Warp drive active.
Is the Galactic Marauder. You can tell it's a Kronos rather than a Vindicator by the top side of the ship here. You can see the way it kind of sticks up a bit. There are other telltale signs as well, but it's typically found out. But you have nothing on it. Why not?
Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.
All right, let's see what else they have. Intercept the saboteurs, which is Federation Navy, Galenti, this is the station, and Viral Agent, who is the faction? Serpentis is the faction. Serpentis typically is thermal and kinetic damage, which I'm already fitted for. Let's go ahead and grab my other ship, which is a Proteus. Here because it's getting a bit boring only being able to target five enemy ships at any given time. This is a auto targeting system, but it's not just for automatic targeting. You can leave the module inactive and it will actually allow you to target two extra targets above your ship's capacity. The ship capacity here is five, but with this module I'll be able to target seven objects, which is very handy when targeting speed for small frigates in these missions can be quite long, so you want to try to lock as many as you can as quickly as possible, because the frigates are the ones that will web or scram you. That's when you get into trouble. Now, a big issue for me with the ship, the resists are extremely high, and I'm even fitted for specific resistance for this mission, which is both kinetic and thermal. As you can see, I have an adaptive, I've also got a repper, I'm to pass out stable, so I can run that repair as much as I want. And basically all my damage type in this ship is done by drones. Wardens for the long range, so the sentry drones. For long range, I've got some hobs for the short range, smaller items like frigates if they get in too close. And then I've got geckos, which is the cleanup crew. High damage, but you don't want to kind of send them into the fray when there's maybe 30 or 40 enemy ships, because if they do get targeted, they'll die like anything else. And these things right now are worth well over 100 million. 120 million to buy one of those geckos. So, without further delay, let's get out here and do this mission. I've got everything I need. Where is it? It's in Ionia, so we don't have to go far. And what have I got to do? Intercept transport ships. On my other screen over here, I've got the Eve survival mission reports. And I'm going to just have a quick look in case there's something I'm missing. Intercept. Saboteurs, which is Serpentis. Plenty of ships here. Scary here. Let's go ahead and undock and do this mission. Faction battleship has a super strong web bonus. This thing catches you with its webs. It'll stop you regardless of what you're running. It'll stop you and then he'll smash you in the face with his guns. Awesome ship, love it so much. But we're not here to look at those ships. Let's go ahead and pocket.
Warp drive active.
See, I'm leaving my auto targeter off. Otherwise, it'll just anything that targets me and hits me, if I have the auto targeter on, anything that hits me will then, my ship will try to target it. I end up then having a bunch of targets up here, wasting all my lock targets that I potentially want to use for other types of targets, and it's a real pain in the ass. So I'll leave this module off. I only have it there just to gain the extra two targets that I have the ability to lock. Okay, there's the gate. These are all frigates. Destroyers. Oh, two, three, four, five. Go ahead and let my hobgoblins take care of these. Drones. Focus fire, not working. go into the
warp drive active.
They're into my armor, so I can activate my armor ripper and keep my. myself in good shape. Protect and then these targets are now quite large at this point, so I'm going to go ahead and bring out my gladiators. These are heavy, heavy drones. They were gifts from CCP because they get blown up like everything else. There's really not that many of them left, so that's why the price is so ridiculously high. You can see the amount of hit points they hit for it. They have a omni damage type, so they hit for every type of damage, which makes them really fun to have. Because it doesn't matter what faction you're hitting against, they'll hit them hard regardless. Just need to make sure they do not die, because that's a lot of money to throw away. Once I've got these guys close by cleared out, I'm going to pull in my geckos and drop my wardens again and hit these guys from a distance. It's by far the most effective way of doing it. The sentries are good at that for the long range. But also keeps my geckos from going in at that kind of distance, because if I do need to pull them back because they're getting targeted or shot at, then that distance that they would need to cover to get back to me could be the difference between them living and dying. Because even though they are retreating towards me, they'll be retreating in a straight line, which means the transversal is going to be really low, which means they will get hit. So this way I'm keeping my gecko safe and I'm still efficiently hitting from a long distance, which means I'm going to try and reload my spike. Let's go ahead and start pre-locking these guys. Two small ones out of the way first, as usual. And then we've got the cruisers. Pretty significant damage even from this range, 80 kilometer range. See, the wardens are really doing their work there. 800 hit, it's impressive. Don't want these things. What do I need to do with that agent? Do I need to bring it back? Our spies is going with a few combats with that, acquire these goods, yes. So important thing here is this. Well, let's just go ahead and take stuff we want. And we'll leave the these are illegal goods, so I can be fined if I go through any stargates with this stuff. I really don't need it, so, and it's not worth a lot anyway, so I'll leave that there. restaurants in, and we have everything we need. Double check that loot. Confiscated viral agent. Let's have a look and make sure we have enough. The details. And 60 bars, so we have everything we need. Go ahead and dock, and then we can go back with our Noctis.
Warp drive active.
There's just quite a few left in salvage.
Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.
Thank you. Let's clear out my ship here.
Warp drive active.
Agents. Mission record key. Storyline. Record cleaning. Let's have a look at the survival and see what it says. Marks. We got hostages. This is kinetic and thermal damage, which I'm already fit for, so that's cool. Let's go ahead and leave that mission journal open. This is where we want to.
Warp drive active.
a bit boring, but it is quite a bit of money as well, so it's worth it.
Thank you.
Warp drive active. Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.
Noctis. Let's go back to this because I think there's quite a lot of DPS coming inbound on this one, so let's see. What's my resists? Kinetic and thermal are already really good. So let's see what they're like when I undock. Enough ammo. Yeah, that's fine. Cargo container. Okay, let's go and do this.
Warp drive active.
Hardeners, and let's check our resists again. 91 and 96% resists, that's pretty awesome. Problem is this, we're going to get unknown damage types. In one pocket there's an acidic cloud. There's 7, 2 groups of 7 ships. So do we want to do the acidic cloud, or do we want to do the patrol area with all the DPS? Down pocket 2 is just there. Few ships. Let's do a patrol area. I want to get some. There's frigates here as well. Web and scramble. Yeah, let's do this one. Like there's mostly short range, so it's fine. Group of pirates will be waiting.
Warp drive active.
1000 DPS, huh? 1000 DPS. this guy. Ah, oh, kill him. Try it. Okay. Everything I'll need. Preheat my prepper. Sitting still isn't the best way to mitigate damage, but I have such a high resist around my ref as well, it would keep up now that I have some of the DPS off the field. I'm scanning local here for combat scanner probes, because I see in local we have a player who is orange. Yeah, tier extraction. Typically, they are mission looters. They basically they're out to screw up the game for other people, more or less. New player training. Yeah, right. Teaching new players how to get ganked. Basically, they're like goons. And what they do is they are going to use combat scanner probes to try and scan down and get the location of my MTU. Because they are allowed to target my MTU without Concord intervention, and if they blow up my MTU, any loot that's inside, they are able to take, and there's over a million here in loot. So problem is, if I engage them, I then become a suspect myself, which means that they probably have friends waiting to jump in at that point and then blow me up. They can gank me that way, and I don't really want to lose a 1 billion ISK ship to these assholes. So that ain't happening. That's why I'm keeping an eye out for combat probes, because they'll have to get quite close to me to be able to scan my MTU. So, that's that. Return. Let's scoop this. Scoop the cargo hold. I have the location bookmarked, I believe. I do. I will come back for that.
Warp drive active.
Okay, well, I'll take another drill at this point. Let's get the smaller guys first. This location two, because I have got to get in here. Stick the card out. I want to get this before somebody comes in here and takes it on me.
Thank you.
can see that they're still taking damage as they're returning to me, so that's what you gotta be really careful with that. I can still hit this guy with my gun, so. As soon as they are targeting me. Which they are now doing.
Warp drive active. Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.
Thank you.
Warp drive active. Warp drive active. Warp drive active. Thank you. Warp drive active.
Okay, I need to take a break here. Some guests arriving later. okay, that's stuff for this one. I'll see you guys again.